He gave new tax credits to big firms of such profitable companies such as General Electric, Johnson, and Associated Bank go year after year without paying Wisconsin income tax. The question is in three parts, which you have on the table. First, do you believe in a balanced approach to budgeting, an approach which doesn't just reduce funding, but also finds additional sources of revenue? Secondly, will you build Wisconsin Department of Revenue's capacity to catch tax cheats? And finally, do you support a Buffett rule for corporations to force all big profitable companies to pay a fair share of income tax?
The question is balancing the budget by tax cuts alone. I think that there's some misconception about what Governor Walker actually did in this budget. The governor had more money than we had in 2009. The governor started with half of the budget deficit that we had. We had 6.6 billion, he had 3.5 by his numbers. And he used 1.3 billion in dollars that the governor campaigned against, tax dollars, changes to the tax code that were made in 2009, things that we've heard about in this campaign, like combined reporting, which is commonly called the Las Vegas loophole, which wasn't repealed, contrary to what some of the other opponents of mine have said. It wasn't repealed. It's still there. And the governor used that money to balance the budget, even though he campaigned against it. Not many people know that. And if you want the Fiscal Bureau paper, I'd be happy to get it to you. When I put together an alternative budget a year ago, I knew there was more money in this budget. And I knew that we could make different choices without raising taxes. And that's exactly what I did. I respected the fact that the governor didn't want to raise taxes. I agree that the tax code needs to be revised, that we need to take a look at it. But I'm giving him the respect, saying, okay, we'll accept that we're not going to raise taxes. And I rearranged the priorities. And I fully funded tech colleges. I fully funded local government. I got up to 85% of all the cuts in schools. I fully funded things that we never should have cut, like school breakfast and school lunch and homeless veteran programs and family care. Because I know that this wasn't about priorities because we were broke. This was about priorities because the governor was ideologically driven in the decisions that he made. We need to move to a fairer tax system, and we made changes in the 2009 budget that we're now actually benefiting from, including taxing the top 1% before it was popular. Bet you didn't even know that part. Including something called streamlined sales tax, which makes it easier for businesses that do online to pay their sales tax that they owe, the online businesses, so that they actually fairly compete with mainstream. Do we need to add more employees to the Department of Revenue? Yes, absolutely, we do. And all the research has been done on how this is very cost effective for the state. Those employees bring back many times over their salaries. And when we think about the Buffett rule, I think the Buffett rule does apply to the federal government, not the state government. But when we talk about taxing corporations and paying their fair share, I'm going right back to combined reporting because that's what that's all about.